मॉर्निंग स्टैंडर्ड 8 एंड वेलकम टू टुडेज क्लास। टुडे आर गोइंग टू रीड द लिटरेचर चैप्टर 5। देयर इज अ ब्यूटीफुल पोएम दैट इज द रेलवे जंक्शन। ओके, रेलवे जंक्शन इज अ ब्यूटीफुल पोएम रिटन बाय द वाल्टर जॉन डी लामारे एंड इट डील्स विद द मिस्ट्री ऑफ द अननोन एंड ए सिंबॉलिक ऑफ द जर्नी ऑफ लाइफ। ओके, दैट इज अ जर्नी ऑफ life where the poet himself is sitting and he is waiting for the traveling to his destiny and the many other like him have the different roads to the travel or to travel. Okay, from the first line let us start. From here through tunnel gloom the track fork into two and one of these wheels onward into the darkening hills and one towards distant seas. Okay, saying that from here through the tunnel gloom of the track. Okay, the poet starts that the where is at a crossroad. Okay, fork into two means there is a railway track and there is a cross track. Okay, two track crossed each other, that means the track is dividing into the two. Okay, one of these wheels onward into darkening hills and one towards distant seas. Okay, saying that there is he sees that the alternate future in front of him which can take him to the very different destinations. That means one is into darkening hills. Darkening hill means what? The darkening hills, and other one is the distant seas. Okay, so the distant seas, that means one can take him to a harsher future, that the darkening hills, and other to the hope he is for himself. Okay, so there are two ways, and on the two ways he is deciding on which way it leads to what type of destinations. Okay, whether he is going to take a wrong destinations or a to the destinations where he is hopefully waiting for. Okay, so in this way, moving on to the next lines, they are saying how still it is the signal light, a set of sun signs palely green, a thrush sing, other sound there is none, nor travel to be seen. Saying that the poet takes one of the track, okay, and realize how different it is from the life he has lived so far, and comparing how still it is to where the late there was a throng. Okay, in the journey he has decided that to undertake, he finds the thing are quite different, right? Here that is why in the same it is saying that the next line, where late there was a throng and now in a peace while I sit alone, though soon at the appointed hour I shall myself be gone. Okay, I shall myself be gone. He is saying that quite silent, that is he is sitting in the quite silent because there is seems to be no one with him at this moment of the time, and for a brief moment he finds a peace that he has always strived for, right? But he also knows that the peace, this peculiar solitude, is momentary, and very soon some people will join this train of the life, and once again this brief and the solitude will be gone. That is why saying though soon at the appointed hour I shall myself be gone. Okay, in the last answer, I shall myself be gone. And here I will, nobody will tell me where I to reach to the destination. That means everyone is waiting for their journey to the destination for their life. So that is why saying I also have to go by myself. Okay, in the fourth lines it is written that but not their way, the bow-legged grooms, the person in black and the widow and Sons, the seller with his case and the gun, gamekeeper with his gun. Okay, and in the next line it is saying that fair one too, discreetly veil all who so mutely come and went will reach those far nocturnal hills or source ere night is spent. Okay, or source ere night is spent. Let me explain, saying that here, but not their way. The bow-legged grooms, the person in black, and the widow and sons, the seller with his case, the gent gamekeeper with his gun. Saying here, the poet talks about the various people. Okay, the various people who he sees climbing is this train of life, and there are people of various ways. He notices. Okay, various ways means various color of people. Or people having various various hopes, various anticipating there. So he realized that all of them people like him, all of them trying to mutely find their own destinations. Okay, mutely find their own destinations. That is why saying that is fair one to distinctly wind all who so mutely came and went, all reach those for nocturnal hills or source ere night is spent. All of them are trying to the mutual to mutely find their own destinations, but he expresses a fear for all of them and a fear that he feels for himself too. So whether they would or for that matter even he reach the destinations, so he has chosen for himself. But it is the nocturnal hills and the source, okay, where the ere night is spent. Okay, nocturnal hill means that is Nishachay. In Hindi you can say the Nishachay Parvatya. Okay, Nishachay Parvatya.
Before the evening, na?
And source, Kinare.
That's okay. Down.
So where the air night is spent. Yeah, where the matlab ki where pehli night is already spent. Okay. And is concerned the poet means I hope I find my destinations. Yeah. Before I die, since I have been started my journey once for my life, okay. So obviously, if I am trying almost and always for all the time, then I might have find my destination before I die. So I nothing know, saying I nothing know why thus we went, where thus we met, their thoughts, their longings of their fate. And what shall I remember except the evening going late? Okay, in this stanza saying that I nothing know why we met and their thought that their longings, hope, their fates, and what shall I remember except the evening growing late? Okay, here saying that brings out that though he has traveled some distance with the co-traveler in this train of life, but he has never known their inner desires and the reasons they climbed this particular train. Okay, what is the reason behind it? So that is why saying that here through tunnel room the track forked into the two of these. One into the darkening hills leads on, and one towards distant seas. Okay, so saying that he is saying that the sea somberly states that the only things which he is presently aware of is, other than the fact it's getting late or in the evening. Okay, that is that he is at a crossroad of life. And one which can lead to the darkening hills, and other which leads to the distant sea. That means what? The darkening hills is the fear of the decision gone wrong, and the distant sea means he is assuming eternally with the eternal hope he has in the decision where he has taken. Okay, or to the decisions of the a fine decision where he has taken. Okay. So the poet has here put his actual anguish in a very small phrases that it struck me much later. So he has put his simply as evening growing late, poet is growing older, and the wondering whether the he is about to reach his destination or not. So he has made his correct or wrong, whatever the decision he has made, and that is why in this poem he realized and he wanted to say that the people will meet in the future as much as people who have been in his past of the journey of his life. Okay, so this is all about the poem, and the question answer of this poem or the chapter will be sent soon. See the book, okay, match your lines and try to understand. Thank you.